The anatomical neck of the humerus marks the junction of the head of the humerus with the rest of the upper end. Next is the surgical neck. It is present or it marks the junction of the whole of the upper end with the shaft. Next is the epiphyseal neck. It is just 0.5 cm above the surgical neck of the humerus. Now we will begin with the attachments related to the humerus. First attachment is, we will be dealing with the greater tubercle and the lesser tubercle. On the greater tubercle, there is supraspinatus, then infraspinatus, then on the lesser tubercle, there is subscapularis. This is intertubercular sulcus. In the intertubercular sulcus, on the floor is attached the latissimus dorsi. On the lateral lip, there is the pectoralis major attachment. And on the medial lip, there is the attachment of the teres major. Then comes the deltoid tuberosity. On this deltoid tuberosity, there is V-shaped insertion of the deltoid muscle. Then we come to the medial border. In the middle 1.5 cm of the medial border, there is insertion of the curaco brachialis. On the anterolateral surface and anteromedial and anterolateral surface, brachialis takes its origin. This marks the origin of the humeral head of the pronator teres. And here, on the lateral supracondylar line, the upper two-thirds gives origin to the brachioradialis and the lower one-third gives origin to the extensor carpi radialis longus. Now, this lateral epicondyle will form the common extensor origin and this medial epicondyle will form the common flexor origin. Just above the deltoid tuberosity, there was an oblique line. This oblique line will provide attachment to the lateral head of the triceps, while the posterior surface, lower part of the posterior surface, will provide attachment to the triceps, medial head. Now, what is the capsular ligament? The capsular ligament, it surrounds the globular head. Now I am marking the capsular ligament. It will surround the complete margin of the globular head except inferiorly. It will dip down 2 cm below to enclose the shaft of the humerus. Also here in near the intertubercular sulcus, where it will enclose the tendon of the long head of the biceps. On the medial and lateral, it will provide attachment to the ulnar collateral ligament and radial collateral ligament.